when it comes to music, the music that we were doing those days helped Nigeria. Because it's not like what they are doing now. What we did those days is music from our own language, from our own reading, from our own music, but the high life, the Afrobeat is more in the background is really, really Nigerian.
October 1st, 1960, Nigeria declared independence. Highlife music was at its peak and Lagos was the place to be. Prosperity gave rise to an expanding record industry and a fresh wave of musicians fused older highlife forms with new influences like funk, soul, and disco.
In the 50s and 60s, it was chart.
Love Lagos life. Everything was in order. People were. The social life was fantastic. There were no armed robbers, there was no danger. You going about in the night, you could as a young man, go in a pub crawl. And then when you were doing that, you went into these pubs or nightclubs to listen to seasoned, disciplined new artists, musicians. And you learned a lot from what they had to tell you through their music.
Some pubs will close at 10 o'clock, while others start at 10. They close at about midnight, 1, 2. From 2 o'clock, you close, you move around to another place. And the last port of call usually was Bobby Benson's Cabin Bamboo. In those days, it used to be the last port of call and where every pub caller were assembled in the early hours, you say about from 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock in the morning, that's where we assemble. We keep calling, musically, morally and otherwise, from one nightclub to the other, to another, and so on until sunrise. This is out.
We have so many clubs in Lagos around 60s. We have Wayfarers Hotel, we have Reefs Hotel, we have Abalabi, we have Empire, we have so many, lots of clubs in Lagos where we are playing there.
Mo kere si namba wa, awon mode won ipere.